What is going on, good people of YouTube? It's me, Chavez. And in today's video, we are opening up this box of PSA graded cards. Now, I'll be honest with you, I already opened it up just to take a peek inside, just to make sure what I thought is inside is actually inside, because nowhere on this label does it read PSA, PSA headquarters, or anything like that. So I just needed to make sure that, you know, my cards were in here. But once I saw them, I quickly taped it back up and we're ready to roll this video. I'm excited to share with you what's inside of here. So if you can dig that, be sure to stick around, like, subscribe, click that notification icon, because it all means a ton. And with that being said, let's have a little fun.
What is going on, everybody? Thank you so much for stopping by the channel and checking this video out. I am really excited about this one because I've been waiting a while for this one because of the time it takes to get cards graded. But I finally got my PSA submission in, my very first PSA submission in, and I'll be sharing with you the contents of this box right here. First time submitting with PSA, and I am really excited because even though the format has changed with PSA, you no longer have to join those live events and then, wait for the countdown to begin and then get your allocation and all that stuff, and the frustration that comes with those, because sometimes you get that message saying that, you know, time has run out or spaces have filled up. But I finally got my place in line and was able to submit some cards. But that has changed since I believe a month ago, and now as long as you're a PSA member, you can just submit your cards and don't have to do any live events or anything like that. But that's what I had to go through to get these cards graded, and I'm happy they're here, safe and sound. Funny, because when this box arrived, well, first of all, I got an email notification saying that the box was not delivered because it required a signature and I was at work. So I had to wait another day. I rescheduled the delivery for June 7th and even took off work to come home and meet the mail carrier here. And he told me that he didn't bring the package because it takes 24 hours to process in the system, that he'll bring it tomorrow, which is Wednesday. So I went back to work pissed off. And then Wednesday, it arrived at my door. They left it in a locker here on property, so there was no signature required, but took an extra 2 days to get these things. And of course I was excited and chomping at the bit to get these things. So it was almost just like my patience were being tested, but they're here nonetheless, and I'm ready to open this thing up. Like I said in my intro, there is no PSA address or sticker or anything like that, so I was assuming this was PSA cards, but I didn't know. So I did open it just to open and peek inside. I didn't pull the cards out, but I did remove some of the padding inside just to see if I could find out if indeed these were PSA graded cards. And I did see the corner of some of the slabs, so I just boxed it back up, taped it up, and we're good to go. So we're gonna go ahead and open this up now. And once I open this up, I'm gonna go ahead and switch the camera angle so that way I can have a seat. Right now I'm standing up and trying to open this up. I'm trying to do it so that the camera doesn't shake, and trying to do it so that I don't cut another finger like that. That was fun. All right, so this is what the inside looks like. I have had cards graded through SGC, so I was excited to see how they compared. If I remember correctly, the padding was pretty similar here. All right, so it's this little box here that contains the cards. And I just like opened that up real quick, saw what was inside, boom, put it back in, boom. All right, so like some of my eBay submissions, I do know what is in this box. I remember the cards I submitted. I submitted 12 cards through to PSA. Each one is $50 to get graded. It's very expensive, but I don't care what people say about the price. I have never had cards graded by PSA, and I wanted to finally get it done. So I literally paid the price. I paid the price to get these things graded, and to me, it's worth it. Now, will I continue using PSA in the future? I guess it just depends on the card. Currently, there are certain cards that grade better and hold more value when they are in a slab, a PSA slab, over SGC or any other company, and you know, vice versa. So I guess it just depends on the card itself. But without further ado, let's get going. All right, so got this nice little box here. Nice little wadded up brown paper. All right, here you go. That's it. That's what the big fuss is all about. Is it back? All right, cool. This is the invoice, I'm sure. So there's my submission number. Maybe I'll do a video on how to submit cards to PSA. If you're new to the system or new to the hobby, maybe you'll find it of use. But even if I don't, there are so many great videos out there that have covered this topic. It's kind of how I learned and you know, kind of where I got my my motivation from to submit cards. It's kind of scary at first because, you know, you don't want to invest your money into something and have it come back and the return on your investment is terrible, right? You want to make sure that you're submitting cards and not flooding the market with garbage cards. But then you come across cards that are real, you know, sentimental to you, or they mean something more than just like a typical base card does, and it is worth it to get graded, and you don't care, you know, what it costs, or you know, if it's a 10 or not. But it is a little nerve-wracking, a little scary cleaning the cards and wiping them down and placing them perfectly into the sleeve, and then placing that into you know, a top loader. But you know, once you send them off, that's it, they're out of your hands, and then you hope for the best. So here we go. Card number one is a 2011 Topps Chrome refractor of Colin Kaepernick. Came back an 8. Womp womp. All right, so a little disappointed because obviously everybody thinks they pull 10s. I really did think this one was gonna grade a 9. I really did. When I looked at the centering, I saw, you know, I saw good things. The corners look good. I think, I don't know. I was kind of concerned, like, I don't know if you can see like that down there when I tilt it. It looks like it's not, it looks a little like it's bumpy. I don't know if I can like show it, but I saw that and I just thought it was part of the image, and I thought, you know, you see how it's kind of like running off, like outside the border right there. I thought like, oh man, maybe they're gonna, you know, count that against me, or maybe it's just part of the card. I did Google this card and saw a card, all the cards had that, you know, defect or not defect or whatever feature. So I was like, oh, what the hell, you know, this thing, you know, this is the way the card looks. So yeah, looks good on the back too. So maybe there's just surface damage or smudges or something on it that I just didn't see. Similar to the Justin Herbert Prism Black that graded out a 6 last time through SGC. Something was wrong with that shit. I didn't see it. But yeah, nonetheless, I think everybody's very familiar and up to date with Colin Kaepernick and all the pushback he's getting from the NFL. I was a fan of his prior to everything. I'm still a fan of his, and I just respect people who stand up for what they believe in and don't care how it's going to impact their future or career, because that's the person they are. They're just going to be who they are and be as true as possible. And I think, man, you just need more people like that. Why wouldn't you want that kind of person around you in your organization, you know? Anyway, he's been trying out for teams. He never gets a spot. All these backup quarterbacks in the NFL kind of suck. Here's this guy on the street. Give him a job, right? You know, give him a spot on a team. He can go into a handful of teams right now and probably compete for a starting role or a backup role, honestly. But nonetheless, big fan of Colin Kaepernick. I've had this card since 2011. I remember when I pulled it, I thought it was the coolest thing ever. And I'm actually very surprised that I kept it in such good condition. Obviously not great condition, but good condition. So when I got back in the hobby and started going through all my stuff, I saw it. I said, man, that's a cool looking card. And I looked up the value of the PSA 10 for this card, and it was nice amount. All right, let's give it a shot. So came back an 8. I'm not terribly upset, but I would have liked to see a 9. All right, this card here is, boom, a 1997 Flair Showcase of Kobe Bryant, row 3. Came back another 8. A little disappointed with this one, I'm not gonna lie, because it looked good, damn it. But I will say that I did not pull this card. I purchased the raw card on ComC. Purchased a few of them. This was the one out of the 3 that I bought that looked the best and I thought had the best chance to grade well. It obviously could be worse, but it could be better. A 9, right? I mean, for a 25-year-old card, I think it held up pretty well. Whoever had it before me did a great job of keeping up with it. Yeah. You'll hear people say, like, these kind of cards with, like, that reflective surface, the holographic surface, that refractor, that chrome surface, they're a little hard to keep up over the years because they get dirty, they collect dirt and dust, and it's just hard to, like, maintain the original form. I think it's hard to keep those paper cards up over the years because this coloring and the corners can dull out and get, like, bent. It's hard to keep cards in good shape, you know, over the years, especially when you're talking 10, 15, 20 years. So I would have liked to see this in a 9, but man, it's a good looking card. It's Kobe Bryant, man. I love Kobe. Favorite player, favorite athlete ever, honestly. So it's a good looking card. Why not get it graded? Throw it in a slab. Wish that slab was a 9. All right, moving on. Card number 3. Boom! First PSA 10. It is a 2018 Panini Donruss Kobe Bryant Winter Stays Gem Mint 10. Now, I was a little surprised, not with the grade, because I think everything I pull is going to be a 10, but when I pulled this from the pack, I was surprised at how good it looked. I pulled this from a 2018 box of Optic because I was chasing Luka. And I didn't find a Luka, but I found this and a few other good cards. But when I pulled it from the pack, it just looked so damn good. Centering's good, border's good, corners look good, front and back. And I was like, man, that's gotta be at least a 9. So I was very, very optimistic and very happy when I saw this card because, again, Kobe Bryant, yep. But then it just looks so good. That purple and black, that color combo looks so good. So my first PSA 10 right there. Card number 4, boom. First PSA 9, it is a 2021 Mosaic Genesis of Derek Carr. Derek, don't call me David Carr, mint 9. So pulled this Genesis from a hanger box that I purchased at Walmart. So retail is doing us right. I saw it, I liked it. I am a fan of Derek Carr. I don't love Derek Carr. I don't think he's the best. He's definitely not as bad as people think, and people sleep and they just underestimate this guy. And I think he's gonna have a strong year. I'm excited to see what this offense looks like in Vegas with him and Devontae Adams. Nonetheless, it's my first Genesis pull. Man, you know, I had to get this graded, you know. It's not a Genesis of like Mark Schlereth or, you know, like some second string defensive end. It's a starting quarterback in the NFL who's going to have a good, you know, 4,000 plus yard season and make the playoffs. So yeah, I was excited when I got this card. I'm happy with the grade. Obviously, you want a 10, but obviously not every card can be a 10. So moving on to the next card. Boom! Not every card can be a 10, but this one is. It is a 2021 Absolute Red Squares of Mac Jones. And I pulled this from a jumbo pack of Absolute Football. It was a jumbo box of jumbo packs. I don't know how that's worded, but basically it was a box of 12. I did a video on this as well. And I pulled it. And I loved it. It just looked so cool. It was like, every time I tilted it, it was like, oh, there's something different. Oh, look at that. I didn't see that at first. And it just, like, the design keeps going. So, obviously, Mac Jones has a bright future in the NFL. A lot of hype around him going into his second year. But, man, this is a very awesome card. And not only is it an insert, it is a numbered insert. And it is numbered to 4... Oh, can you see that? $4.99 right there, the bottom. $4.99. There you go. So yeah, very happy with this result. So 5 cards pulled so far, 2 tens, 1 9, and 2 eights. Boom! Another Gem Mint 10. Now this is a 2021 Donruss Downtown of Brian Dawkins. Came back a Gem Mint 10. I am pulling all these cards out of like blaster boxes and hanger boxes. Now this was pulled from a box of Donruss Football. It was just a blaster box and I pulled it and damn, I was surprised that it was in there, but it is a good looking card. Look, I'm not a Philly fan. I'm not a like Dawkins diehard fan, but the man was a great player for the Eagles. He was a badass safety. And for a while, you could argue that he was the top safety in the league. But the downtown insert just looks so good. I had to get it graded. These cards, I wouldn't say they're ultra rare, but they're not easy to come across, right? You're going to pull, like in a box of Optic, you're going to pull 5 Express Lanes or 3 Winter Stays or something like that, you know, but you're not pulling 3 downtowns in a hanger box or a blaster box. So yeah, of course I'm gonna get it graded. It doesn't matter if I'm a diehard Philly fan or not. It's a good looking card of a great player, so very happy with that. So 3 tens, 2 eights, and a 9. Moving into this next card, card number 7. Boom! It is a 2021 Panini NBA Hoops rookie card of Jalen Green. All right, yes, it is a basic rookie card. It is not numbered. It is no parallel. Listen, I'm a Houstonian. I'm from H-Town. The Rockets have not had a bright future in a couple of few seasons, honestly, since Harden left, man. Let's not fake the funk here. Harden's last year or so in Houston wasn't the greatest. Him and Westbrook were not like doing awesome shit, you know. So it's been a while, and they grabbed this kid out the G League, and he had a rough start to the season, but man, he came on strong at the end of the season, much like Cade Cunningham. And there are a lot of rookies in the league that don't have bang ass starts to their career, like Anthony Edwards. People are calling that guy a bust, you know, midway through his rookie season. The kid's like 19 years old, right? So anyway, I have a lot of these Jalen Green rookie cards because I bought a lot of NBA hoops when I got back in the hobby. But out of the, you know, 10 that I have, this one looked the best. So I decided to get it graded. Maybe I'll get the other 8 or 9 graded as well to see if those come back at 10. But this is, you know, more so for like the personal PC, you know. I don't think this one's gonna sell for a high value on my eBay page or anything, but this is more so for me. All right, so moving in to card number 7. We have, did I pick up 2 or 1? Oh, that's 1. Boom! So, a 2021 absolute kaboom of Charles Woodson came back a 9. Listen, again, much like the Dawkins downtown, I'm not a Raiders fan. I am not necessarily a Charles Woodson fan. I mean, but nobody can deny how great of a player this guy was at Michigan, and then the way he just kept excelling in the NFL throughout his career. My first downtown, my first Genesis, these are not easy to come by. I understand that Genesis and Kabooms are now being put into more products, so you're finding them more frequently, but the odds are still not in your favor. So first Kaboom, I actually pulled this Kaboom with that Mac Jones in the same box, or the same pack actually. So that pack, that box of cards treated me really well. But yeah, first Kaboom, had to get it graded. Looks good in the slab. I did notice, I don't know if you can see it, there is a corner, maybe that corner, or maybe it's on the back, I can't tell. But there was a corner where I thought, oh, wow, is that, it must be that one. I didn't know if it was part of the design or if it was kind of chipped. I didn't know, but I wasn't gonna let that stop me from getting it graded. So it came back a PSA 9. Moving in to card number 9. Boom. Now this, I'm a little surprised. I'm not gonna lie. This is a 2013 Top Supreme autograph rookie of DeAndre Hopkins, Gem Mint 10. I bought this card on eBay when the Texans drafted DeAndre Hopkins. I got it for like $4. It was cheap. And I held on to it. And when I got back into the hobby, I saw it and I just didn't know how well it was gonna grade out because of the autograph not being, I don't know how graders look at autographs either. So I didn't want that to be held against the card, but I just didn't feel confident in the centering, and it just didn't look like it would grade out very well. So I held off on it when I sent my submission into SGC. And then when I started getting cards ready for PSA, I said, well, shit, if I'm gonna send cards in, if I'm sending autographs in to be graded, I might as well send autographs in to PSA. Let's see what comes back. Gem Mint 10, so happy with this card. So again, Houston fan, Texans fan, never made it past Baltimore during those tough years. But man, no one can deny how talented DeAndre Hopkins is. The way he played, you know, in Houston, and it's kind of shitty the way his career ended in Houston because Bill O'Brien's such a terrible coach, breaking up that team and shipping him off to Arizona, and then, you know, kind of leaving Deshaun Watson with nothing. You know, now Deshaun Watson's going through what he's going through, but just to think of the like potential badassery Hopkins and Watson could have, you know, put together in Houston for the next 5 years or so. All right, moving in. Card number, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is card number 10, excuse me. Boom, all right. So now we got the 10s rolling. Now we got 10s rolling. We got 1, 2, 3, 4. This is Gem Mint 10 number 5. Nice. All right. This is a 2019 Hoops Premium Stock of Ja Morant Silver Prism Gem Mint 10. Look, I bought a box of NBA Hoops Premium Stock. Love this card. Love this brand. I love it more than the NBA Hoops, you know, original cards, just because of the card, the NBA, the premium stock cards are just better quality. They're stronger looking. They just look better. Like, optic cards look better than regular Donruss cards. Pulled it from the pack, immediately sleeved it up. I love the card itself. I love him about to just dunk on, who is that? Who's number 40 for the Kings? I don't know. Is that Wayman Tisdale? No. He's about to throw it down. This dude is like, nah, I ain't getting in the way of that. Anyway, came back at 10. Very happy with that. Centering looked good. Edges looked good. Corners looked good. Why not, man? Throw it in a slab. Let's see what we can get at 10. We did. Awesome. Very happy with that. All right, we have two more cards to go. And boom. This one I'm a little disappointed in. I'm not going to lie. It is a 2014 Panini Prism Freshman Phenoms of Joel Embiid. Came back an 8. It is a prism. It's a silver prism. Boom. See that right there. Yeah, man. I don't know. I thought it was going to be a 9 or a 10. I keep saying it. You know, when I hear myself say it, it's like, of course you did. Why would you think it would be a 6 or a 5, right? Of course you think it's going to be a 9 or 10. But it looked good. This card looks good. So again, these cards with like this reflective surface, these like, you know, there's something with them. Like, I need to learn how to clean these better. Or maybe just not send these types of cards in after, you know, a certain year. Man, this is a 11-year-old card. This is an 8-year-old card. Maybe there's something to it. Maybe I need to do a better job of buying raw cards before I get them graded. But nonetheless, I like Joel Embiid a lot, man. He's one of my favorite players in the NBA right now. I love his candidness. I love his transparency. I love his no bullshit attitude. I love his performance on the court. I wish he could stay healthier in the playoffs, because each year he just breaks something or bruises something, and it honestly does cost his team games. That team is not built to win without him. They're just not. So I hope he can keep his body, you know, together for the next few years, and hopefully Philly can make a run. That's after Boston wins a couple of championships, that is. And then maybe they'll leave some scraps on the table for Philly. But nonetheless, I was a little disappointed that he did not win MVP this year. Jokic had an amazing season, but man, so did Joel Embiid. All right, so another 8. Not happy with that. All right, last card. Boom! A 2004 Topps Chrome of Manu Ginobili, Mint 10. Now, what's the significance of this card? Listen, Manu's in the Hall of Fame. He's going to the Hall of Fame. Great player. Crushed it with the Spurs. Has a gazillion championships. I mean, this card looked good. I bought a few off ComC. Maybe I need to stop buying shit off ComC. Maybe that's the problem. But I bought a few off ComC. They came in. I thought they all looked good, but this is the one I chose to get graded. But came back a 9, so I'm not terribly disappointed with the grade. It's a 2004. It's an 18-year-old card. It's hard to keep these cards in gem mint 10 condition, you know, for that long. So, you know, this is a good grade. And in my opinion, this is a good grade. So this is another one for the PC. So I guess all of them, you know, you can say are for the PC. You know, a couple of them, maybe you look at and say, oh, I wonder how much I can get for that particular card. You know, but we get things graded for different reasons. My reasoning is based off of wanting to gain more exposure to the hobby. I don't have very many graded cards. You know, through my own submissions, I've purchased graded cards through eBay and ComC, but I want to continue to submit cards, and hopefully my eye becomes better at looking at these cards so that I'm sending in, you know, nothing but tens. But I think there's been a great deal of improvement from SGC submission to PSA submission. I have more tens in this submission than I did in my SGC submission, so I'm happy about that. And that's it. that's the video. Thank you all so much for sticking around. A little longer video, but it was a fun one. Appreciate the patience. If you haven't done so, be sure to do so on your way out to like, subscribe, click the notification icon, because it truly, truly means a ton to me. And I'm just gonna get these all in frame. So see if we can get all the labels, all the grades in there. Yeah, it means a ton to me. Thank you so much. And until the next video, Chavez is out.